people have used surgery to manage back pain for a long time, and some people have believed that the joints of the back are, in their own right, painful. And we know, for example, with an arthritic hip, that we can remove that and put in a hip replacement, and often that will reduce or stop the pain. So people have tried to do that with the back. It's less successful. It may also be that the spine is moving in an abnormal way. It may be unstable, and therefore if you fuse or try and get one bone to heal to the other, that may also help pain. And if the anatomy is distorted and there's pain, then by surgical means, if you try and restore the abnormal anatomy, that may also be helpful. So those are some of the rationales that are used for offering surgical treatment. Now, the other line, which also goes back certainly to the to World War II and maybe before that, that people found that intensive rehabilitation was also an effective way of managing chronic back pain. And particularly the RAF used this to keep their aircrew in action. And it's rather gone out of fashion. But with some modern attachments, particularly so-called talking therapy or cognitive behavioural therapy, this we now have a sort of package of treatment that people do for maybe 3 or 4 weeks at a time to help people restore function. So we set up a study to compare these two completely different sorts of treatment. Surgical treatment, a very major effect compared with intensive rehabilitation. And we set up what's called a randomized trial. In other words, our patients and the treating surgeons were not able to choose which of these treatments were offered. And it's very difficult to do these sort of studies in any area, but particularly here where you're choosing between really two radically different approaches. Anyhow, we managed to recruit over quite a long period 349 patients, and we've now got a 7-year follow-up on this study. And I'm just going to put up one slide of the, just to say that, so we randomised them either to surgical treatment or to rehabilitation. Now, not everybody got surgery in the surgical arm, and not everybody got rehabilitation in the rehabilitation arm. This is what happens in these sort of trials, and the various reasons why that doesn't occur. But most people got the allocated treatment. And then this summarizes the result. And we used a scale called ODI, or Oswald Street Disability Index, which is a self-report scale and essentially produces 0 to 100, 0, there are no symptoms at all, and 100, you certainly wouldn't be listening to this lecture. So, We had a sort of baseline measurement, which we called naught in this. And people who improved at 2 years would be one of each of these represents an individual. So this individual has improved, say, 21 points on that scale. This individual has improved 60 points. These individuals have got worse by 40 points. So this represent below represents improvement, and above makes it worse. So like many treatments, it doesn't always work. But if you look at those two, there's not a lot to choose between them. The dotted line is the mean of all those values, and you can see that the mean improvement for surgery is a little bit better than the mean improvement for rehabilitation, but not a great deal different. So that makes you think. And in fact, we've now followed people up for 7 years, and if anything, the people who had rehabilitation are doing a bit better than the surgery. There's certainly not much to choose between them still. Now, there are various ways of looking at these results, and this is one of the ways, a rather complicated drawing. But essentially, what we've got here is the mean value of improvement, the same as we saw on the other slide, and an estimation of error. And essentially, we could see about a 4-point difference on this scale in favour of surgery. Now, that is statistically significant. The question is it clinically significant? Is it worth going through an operation for 4 points of value on this scale. Now, when we were setting this up, we thought that 4 points was about the minimally clinically important, but that probably is pretty generous, and other people have put it as high as 6 or 10. You can set the bar where you want, but it's a very fine difference, really, whether you would want to go through an operation or have intensive rehabilitation. So we saw this, and the question then is, well, what difference does that make? We saw it as being support for intensive rehabilitation. And unfortunately, this isn't all that available, even now, all these years later, even though we've done this study. But they are gradually coming, they're coming, sprouting up in various places. And so we really strongly believe now that this rehabilitation approach should be tried before you even think about having surgery for back pain. There are other sorts of back problems which probably for which this isn't appropriate, but we're talking about people with chronic back pain. The other thing to say is, well, maybe it's not a very good operation, spinal fusion, maybe we should find something better. So people have looked at disc replacement, rather like hip and knee replacement, which have been so successful. But actually, the results of disc replacement are not much better than those of spinal fusion. They may be a little bit better, but it's a very big operation to do, and whether it's going to stay with us or not, I'm not sure about. The other thing is more major things. If you get bent over and that produces back pain, should we do something to straighten you up? Should we take a great wedge out of your back and straighten you up? It is possible to do very major things, which for some people can be very successful, but then they also can be extremely dangerous. So there are real difficulties about what is the best thing to do. And then finally, should we do better research to understand the processes that underline this so that we can come up with better things? And that's what Jill has devoted many years to doing, and she'll tell you a bit about what progress has been made. So I'm going to stop there and...